Hello everyone, in this lecture we are going to discuss this Laplace inverse example. This question asked by the student in comment section, so that's why we are discussing the solution of this problem. If you have also doubt in any question, then you can share in chat box or in Telegram. Let's discuss how to solve this Laplace inverse of s upon s square plus 1 into s square plus 4 with the help of convolution's theorem. So what is convolution theorem in Laplace transformation? If we have given function which is in the product form, to find the Laplace inverse of that product function, we use the convolution theorem. Statement of convolution theorem in Laplace inverse is Laplace inverse of f bar of s into g bar of s equal to integral 0 to t f of u g of t minus u du. Otherwise, you may use in the form of integral 0 to t f of t minus u g of u du. So this is the statement of convolution theorem, and with the help of this theorem we can solve this type of example. To use this convolution theorem, we require the function which is in the form of product, or here this is given s upon this term. So firstly we write this term in the form of product. How to write? Here the given function of s is s upon s square plus 1 into s square plus 4. So this is our given function of s, jiska hame kya nikalna hai, Laplace inverse. So firstly write down this function in the form of product. So I write here s upon s square plus 1 into 1 upon s square plus 4. Now this first function we consider as a f bar of s, and second function we consider g bar of s. That means here f bar of s is this function s upon s square plus 1, and g bar of s nothing but the second function, that is 1 upon s square plus 4. So here our f bar of s equal to s upon s square plus 1 and g bar of s equal to 1 upon s square plus 4. Now in the next step, we have to apply the Laplace inverse on both sides. Why we are using Laplace inverse on both sides? Because we use convolution theorem. And convolution theorem ka statement kar raha hai, we require f and g. So what is f and g? It is nothing but the Laplace inverse of our function. So if we know that f bar of s, so Laplace inverse of that f bar of s is nothing but f of t. And Laplace inverse of g bar of s is nothing but g of t. So yahan pe hame convolution theorem use karna hai, that means we required f and g. So here this f bar of s is known, so we have to apply the Laplace inverse. Laplace inverse of f bar of s equal to Laplace inverse of s upon s square plus 1, and here Laplace inverse of this f bar is nothing but f of t. And here right hand side is s upon s square plus 1, and by our standard formulas of Laplace transformation we know that this is a formula of cos t. If it is a s upon s square plus a square, then it is a cos a t. Here it is a 1, so it is a cos t. And same way we have to apply the Laplace inverse on g function. So Laplace inverse of g bar of s equal to Laplace inverse of 1 upon s square plus 4. Now here if we apply the Laplace inverse on a upon s square plus a square, then it is a formula of sin a t. But in this example numerator is 1 upon s square plus a square. A square, that means here it is a 2 square. So this numerator a is missing in this example. So we can write this term as 1 upon 2 Laplace inverse of 2 upon s square plus this 4, we can write 2 square. Taki ye jo inverse wala term hai wo hamare standard formula mein convert hoga, jisme hame standard formula kya hai, a upon s square plus a square. Here therefore 1 upon 2 as it is, and Laplace inverse of this term is sin 2. And left hand side is our g of t. Now as per our convolution theorem, one function we have to replace t by u, and another function we have to replace t by t minus u. So here you can change that t in the form of u in any function. There is no restriction. Either you can change t replaced by u in this function f, otherwise in g. So here I will replace t by t minus u in our function f of t, and in function g we replace t simply by u. So here f of t minus u, if we replace t by t minus u, then it is a cos t minus u. And in second function, if we replace t by u, so it is a 1 by 2 sin 2u. Now here, f of u and g of t minus u. Now here, f of t minus u and g of u, both are known. So by our convolution theorem, Laplace inverse of f bar of s into g bar of s equal to integral 0 to t f of t minus u g of u du. Put the value of our function. So left hand side is Laplace inverse of product of this function is nothing but our quotient, that is s upon s square plus 1 into s square plus 4 equal to integral 0 to t f of t minus u is nothing but cos t minus u into 1 by 2 sin 2u d. Now in the next step, you simply have to solve this integration. Or in integration, if it is a sine into cos or any sine cos cos term, so it is not possible to solve this type of product term directly using product formula. So here we have to use our trigonometric formulas, so that ये product of sine into sine, cos into cos, ये क्या होगा, addition के form में convert हो जाएगा और तब हम उसको solve कर सकते हैं. So how to solve this integration, I will explain in the next slide. So here you have to take 1 by 2 outside, this 1 by 2 you can take outside, remaining integral is integral 0 to t cos t minus u into sine 2u du. Here apply the formula cos a into sine b, cos a into sine b. Formula is 1 by 2 sine a plus b minus sine a minus b. So if we use this formula here, then here 1 by 2 outside as it is, and by formula again we get the 1 by 2. So it is again we get 1 by 2. Integral 0 to t. Firstly, we have to take addition of angle. So it is a sine. Addition of this angle is t plus u plus 2u minus subtraction of the angle. So sine t minus u minus 2u d. Now outside is 1 by 4. Integral 0 to t. Simplify this angle term. So it is a sine t plus u minus sine t minus 3u d. Now one by one solve this integration. So 1 by 4 outside remain as it is. Integration of sine. Integration of sine is minus cos x. If we apply the integration of sine, so integration of sine is minus cos x. So here first term is sine integral is minus cos t plus u minus integration of this sine is here. It is a plus, because already is the sine, and integration of sine is again minus cos. So it is minus is already there. So integration of sine, again we get the minus cos. So that minus minus will be plus. So plus cos t minus 3u divided by, here we are integrating with respect to u, and in this function of sine, u coefficient of this u is minus 3. So that constant we have to divide. So it is a minus 3 divide. Limit is 0 to t. In the next step, we have to put upper limit minus of lower limit. So here, now put upper limit. Here we have integrated with respect to u. So when we are integrating with respect to u, that means we have to put upper limit, lower limit in u. Jahan pe u hoga, wahi pe aapko upper limit, lower limit put karna hai. So upper limit is t. So t, u jahan pe dikh raha hai, wahan pe t put up karenge. So 1 upon 4 outside term as it is, minus cos. Here if we put t, then t plus t is 2t. Minus 1 by 3 cos. Here if we put t, then t minus 3 t is minus 2t. Now put the lower limit. Lower limit is 0. So jahan pe bhi u hai, wahan pe 0 put karenge. Aur lower limit. To minus of lower limit mein ye already minus hai. So we will get minus of minus plus. This is a minus and we are putting minus lower limit. So ye function hoga plus. U के जगह पे 0 पुट कर रहे, so cos t, again it is a minus, so minus of minus lower limit, so it is a plus 1 by 3 cos t. Now in a next step, just we have to simplify, जहाँ पे angle of cos same है, उनको add करेंगे, remaining term will be as it is, और यहाँ पे भी cos minus 2t है, और यहाँ पे cos 2t है. And we know that cos is a even function. So cos ke angle mein agar minus sign hai, so that doesn't matter. Here cos of minus theta is equals to cos theta. So that means ultimately ye dono terms same hai aur ye dono term same hai. So you can add their coefficient. So here 1 by 4 as it is, coefficient of this term is minus 1 minus 1 by 3. Minus 1 minus 1 by 3 is minus 4 by 3 cos 2t, and here it is a plus 4 by 3 cos t. In a next step, we take coefficient, here 4 by 3 is common, so you can take outside, and that 4 numerator and this denominator 4 will be cancelled out. So the final answer is Laplace inverse of s upon s square plus 1 into s square plus 4 equal to 4 cancel out, so remaining is 1 by 3. Here remaining bracket term is cos t minus cos 2t. Just maine yahan pe negative term baad mein likha hai aur positive cos tha, that's why we write here cos t first and then negative term. So this is our final answer. In this way you can try the example of convolution theorem with same process. Thank you.